Hey guys, you're probably here because you want to know all about why those hands and feet are cold all the time. Well, I'm going to answer that question along with many other questions in this week's Responding to Your Comments, where we look at fun questions, we look at science-based questions, but most importantly, we always look at the evidence. This week's video suggestion comes from Lena89. Dear Abraham, why are my hands and feet always cold? And can you please suggest something? This is from the weight loss video. And of course, Lena, I can suggest something. We're gonna look at why your hands and feet are always cold. We're gonna be looking at what the causes are. We're gonna be looking at treatments. And most importantly, we're gonna be looking at when you need to seek medical advice for it. So what are we waiting for? Let's begin. And as always, if you wanna find any specific information, there is gonna be a timestamp below, so feel free to click there if you don't want to watch the full video. However, I would highly, highly recommend that you watch the whole video. Sending you awesome vibes, and let's begin. Okay, so let's begin with the basics. Why do we get cold hands and feet? Well, in some people it can happen time to time, and in some people it can happen all the time, which can be sometimes linked to an underlying medical condition. Now, for those people who usually get it time to time, it's the process that your body does known as thermoregulation. And thermoregulation is really important because what your body's trying to do is keep your core body temperature stable. And your core body temperature is things like your brain, your heart, your inner organs, keep those warmed, and then the peripheries, like your hands and your feet, they go cold. Now, what the body is actually doing here is so intelligent, because what's happening is it's narrowing the blood vessels to your extremities, like your peripheries, like your hands and feet, so more blood is able to go to the core, to those vital organs, like your brain, like your heart. These vital organs that need that blood, they need that heat. It's actually super genius, but the body doesn't understand that it's also super uncomfortable for those cold hands and feet. So that's the body's natural process. But another thing I want to quickly mention is sometimes the blood vessels in your hands can also naturally spasm because of stress, because of anxiety, because of any other reason as well. And it can cause that coldness in the hands. It can cause a color change in the hands. It can cause pins and needles, numbness. And this is known as Raynaud's phenomenon. And if you want more information on it as well, I am going to leave loads more in the description below. There are also some medical conditions that can make this whole experience a lot worse as well. So for example, patients who are diabetic, patients with peripheral artery disease, anemics, if you smoke, all these things can make the condition much worse. There's also some evidence that the coldness of the hands and feet, the extremeness and the pain that people suffer with can be affected by people's age and their gender. And there's also some evidence that women of Asian descent also suffer from it a lot worse than other women. So now we know what causes the cold hands and feet, but how do we treat it? How do we improve those symptoms? So let's first begin with some lifestyle things that everyone can do. I always like to start with these first before we talk about any medicines or anything like that, because I'm sure you're watching this YouTube video because you want to try something right now. So tip number one, the first thing that everyone can do is give the area a good little quick massage. And I know it sounds simple, but it can actually be very beneficial. Now, I know what you're thinking. You're probably thinking to yourself, well, Abraham the pharmacist, how do we do this massage? Well, I'm going to tell you, it's very simple. With the hands, even a quick rub like so can increase the blood flow to the area. However, if you want specific massages, the NHS have a really, really useful article on different massages you can do on the hands and feet. And guess what? I'm gonna leave a link in the description below for you to check it out. Moving on to tip number two, please remember it's all about blood circulation. You know how it works, you know the mechanism of action. One of the things we can do is improving that circulation. So the next tip is all about exercise. And when I say exercise, I'm not saying go to the gym twice a day, 7 days a week, anything extreme or hardcore like that. It can be gentle. You can go for a walk, you can go for a walk up and down the steps, you can do some stretches, you can do some yoga, you can do some breathing exercises. Just gentle, normal stuff. And this is gonna help with the circulation, which is again gonna help with the symptoms. If you want some ideas on exercises, I will leave links to them in the description below and more information in the description too. Now, here's the great thing about exercise. Studies have also shown by doing exercise, you can increase your aerobic capacity. This means how much oxygen your blood is able to carry. So with all of this combined and the increased blood flow and the increased aerobic capacity that we've just spoke about, you're gonna be getting more oxygen to these extremities, you'll be getting more blood there just by simply doing some simple exercise and stretches, even wiggling your fingers, doing the massage and moving your toes, all that sort of stuff, is again gonna help with that blood flow. Moving on to tip number 3, wrap warm. If you find you are someone who's more prone to suffering from cold hands and feet, it may sound obvious, but wrap yourself up warm in cold weather, or even when it's just a bit chilly. So do wear that extra layer or that extra jumper, and when it comes to the extremities like the hands and the feet, you can wear some gloves or you can wear mittens, which are even better because they help to conserve that heat between the fingers as well. Also wear some extra socks and make sure to keep your environment warm, make sure to have the central heating on in the winter, and make sure you're looking after yourself. Moving on to tip number 4, it's all about heat conduction. Look, just by holding something a little bit warmer than you, let's say in your hands, your body is able to conduct that heat. And for example, this can be anything such as a wheat bag that you've warmed up, a hot water bottle, or even a mug. You know, just holding a mug like so can be so, so nice and soothing, and you're gonna conduct that heat and it's gonna help warm up those fingers, those extremities. But please do make sure whatever you're holding is at a safe and suitable temperature, just so you don't burn yourself, because usually when your hands are cold or your feet are cold, you do lose a bit of sense in them as well. And just another top tip, whilst we're on the topic of conduction, some studies have also shown that we conduct heat much better from moistured heat. So for example, a wheat bag, I love a wheat bag, when you touch it you can feel that moisture in it as well, as opposed to chemical heating or anything like that which isn't moisturized, it's a dry source of heat. So just bear that in mind. So moving on to tip number 5, the next thing I wanna discuss is more long-term things, which some people don't realize can massively affect how cold our hands and feet get. So for this, we're gonna be looking at healthy diet, we're gonna be looking at smoking, and we're also gonna be looking at caffeine intake. So eating a healthy, balanced diet ensures your body has all the nutrients it needs for healthy blood cells and a good blood flow. If you don't eat a healthy, balanced diet, it could lead to deficiencies like B12 deficiency or anemia, which, as I mentioned at the beginning of the video, can lead to cold hands and feet. But I'm gonna leave loads more information on these conditions and on how to have a more healthy, balanced diet all in the description below, so feel free to check it out for more information. Now let's move on to smoking. Let's make it plain and simple. If you smoke anything, whether it's cigarettes, cigars, e-cigarettes, shisha, whatever you smoke, it will make your cold hands and feet worse, okay? We know that cigarettes or cigars, for example, they also increase the carbon monoxide within your blood. When we have more carbon monoxide, it reduces the oxygen capacity of your blood, the oxygen capacity we just spoke about. So your blood can hold less oxygen. Less oxygen then go into the extremities, which means your symptoms are gonna get worse. Now, even e-cigarettes that don't contain carbon monoxide can still contain nicotine, and this narrows your blood vessels, again, reducing the blood flow to your extremities. In fact, some studies have even shown that e-cigarettes or vapes that contain no nicotine can again reduce the blood flow to the extremities, like the hands and the feet. So the moral of the story is this: if you have cold hands and feet and you smoke, you really need to quit. Not only is it gonna help with the cold hands and feet, but it's gonna reduce your chances of so many different diseases, so many different cancers, cardiovascular disease, dementia, loads of diseases. So if you're interested in quitting, I will leave more information in the description below. I've also made a video on how to quit smoking, which is really, really useful, and it's helped loads of people. And if you want that, information, I'm gonna leave a link up here and in the description below. And next up, we've got caffeine. So caffeine can cause our blood vessels to narrow as well. And we know all about blood vessels narrowing and less blood supply to our extremities, like our hands and feet. So please see how much caffeine you're having. And remember, caffeine can be found in loads of things, not only coffee, but in teas, in energy drinks, in chocolate, and in a variety of different foods. So please do keep an eye on it and check that you're having the recommended amount as well. I will leave a link in the description below to a really good kind of caffeine calculator if you want to check exactly how much you're having, if it is within the daily recommended amount of caffeine. So those are my top tips if you have cold hands and feet. I really hope you found this information helpful. Like I mentioned at the start of the video, there are various scenarios where you will need to seek medical attention for cold hands and feet. There's quite a few of them. I'm gonna leave a text box somewhere here whilst I'm talking right now, and they're all gonna be there. Please give it a read. They will be in the description below as well. And again, if you have any of your own tips on how you cope with cold hands and feet, please leave a comment below too, because I know I would love to read it. I'm sure people watching this video would love to read it too. So don't forget to leave a comment, and that's the end of this week's video. Always remember that you're awesome, and I will see you next week. So in this week's video, we're looking at how to treat those cold hands and feet. forgot what I was gonna say next. You need to quit smoking. Look, we know that smoking causes heart disease, it causes various cancers, it causes diabetes, it causes strokes, it causes... What am I doing with this list? Why am I listing it? You all know how bad caffeine. Smoking! Oh, I can't speak today. It's actually really warm in here, but I've got these windows open and actually my hands are really cold now. So I'm doing the massaging techniques that require to get that blood flow going. Super important and very helpful. Hey guys, thanks for watching this week's video. Make sure to click that like, follow, or subscribe button now to stay up to date with new weekly videos.